Hey everyone, welcome to week 32 of Operation Lose a Baby Hippo. So this week I would like to talk to you guys about plateaus because for the first time in over 7 months, I have plateaued in my weight loss. I was doing really good and was losing well over the average of 2 pounds a week for the last 7 months. And from last Thursday to this Thursday, I didn't lose anything. When I weighed in on Thursday, I weighed 161.6 according to my scale. However, for some reason, my scale did not sync to the app. And those of you who have the profile scale will know that on the scale, it shows only to the 10th place. So it would be 161.6. But when you log on to the app, it actually rounds up to the 100th place. So 161.6 on the scale might actually be anywhere from 161.56 to 161.65. So it's not as accurate as I would like it to be on the scale. And since for all of my weigh-ins and all of my like tracking my weight loss, I have used the 100th place, I actually weighed in again on Friday, which I typically do not do, just to see if I could get it to sync again. And when I weighed in on Friday, I weighed 161.38. So I had managed to lose 0.22 pounds from Thursday to Friday, which is why I'm using the 161.38 weight on my weekly weigh-in, because that's what shows up on the graph. And just in order to keep everything the same and using the right numbers, that's what I did. So technically, I did lose a little bit of weight this week, but when I weighed in on Thursday, I was pretty much at a plateau. And that is so frustrating for me. I know that when I was going into this diet plan that I had, you know, compensated for the fact that I knew I was going to plateau. So I had given myself, you know, a little over a year to lose 100 pounds because I knew that I was going to have weeks where I wasn't going to lose as much as I wanted, or there's going to be weeks where the weight loss was stalled, because plateaus are just a part of losing weight. However, I had been lulled into a false sense of security because I had not had a plateau in a little over 7 months. And so I was like, I made it to a little bit over 75 pounds gone without plateauing. Like, maybe I can do this and not have a plateau at all. So it's frustrating that it is this far down in the journey that I am plateauing. And it is also frustrating that I was only like 4.4 pounds away from reaching my third weight loss goal, and I thought I was gonna be able to like nail that in 2 to 3 weeks. I was like, oh, that'd be no problem. And now I'm looking at it going, oh, well, what if I plateau for a month? Or what if I, you know, just have stopped losing that 2 pounds a week and I'm now always going to have a much lower weight loss? Like, what if I don't reach that goal? Because I gave myself till April, the first week of April, and I thought that was going to be like a, you know, easy home run, not even worried about it. And now I'm in the, like, first week of February, and I'm a little bit worried because I only lost 0.22 pounds in a week while staying completely 100% faithful to the plan. Had no cheat days, had no cheat meals, had not even had a nibble of something that I shouldn't have, and that's not allowed on Reboot. Like, I was perfectly on plan and had a slow weight loss week, which was frustrating. This is actually tied to be the lowest amount of weight that I've lost in a week from the week that I weighed in after Christmas. And I was super naughty on Christmas, and I still lost the exact same that I lost this week doing everything right, which is frustrating. And I know that I shouldn't be as frustrated because I've lost, at this point now, I'm down 75.8 pounds. Like, that is amazing. That is in 32 weeks. Like, that's insane. I'm averaging still, even with the crappy weight loss this week, I'm still averaging way more than 2 pounds gone a week. But I can't help it. Like, it's just so frustrating. frustrating when I was so close. Like, I honestly was like hoping that this week I could be like, I only have 2 pounds to go. And, or, you know, like I have 2.2 pounds or something. Just anything would have been better than 0.22 pounds. Like, I just wish that I'd lost a little bit more this week so that I could be a little bit closer, because I was super hoping that I could be at that 80 pounds gone by Valentine's Day, because originally the plan was that I was going to have 2 cheat meals this week. One on Valentine's Day, because it is tradition that we go to Olive Garden for our Valentine's Day celebration. We've done that ever since we got together, basically, so that's 5 years, a little over 5 years now. And the second is for Jesse's birthday, because that is coming up the week after, and I'm not going to limit where he wants to go celebrate his birthday because of my dietary restrictions. That's just, it's his day, it's all about him. I'm not going to worry about, you know, oh well, we can't go to that restaurant because there's nothing profile friendly there. Like, no, it's his day, we're going to go celebrate the way he wants to celebrate. So that was the original plan, but since I had plateaued and I typically weigh in only on Thursdays, but sometimes I'll check on like Monday or Tuesday just to see how the weekend went and just to kind of see, gauge how much I'm going to lose that week, just so that I can kind of, and it's nice to know, I get curious, you know, like I'm only a human, I'm a person and I get curious and I want to know. So I had kind of checked on Monday and I'd seen that I hadn't lost a single ounce, like nothing. I was still at 161.6 on Monday. So I kind of had an inkling that I was going to plateau. Like, I knew that, you know, unless something drastic happened between Monday and Thursday, that I wasn't going to lose weight, because that just was the way it was playing out. So I had kind of talked to my fiance and I said, you know, we both have to work on Valentine's Day, and, you know, maybe instead of having, you know, my Valentine's Day cheat meal on Valentine's Day, and then having his birthday cheat meal the next week, maybe if I'm going to plateau, it's not such a good idea to have those 2 cheat meals so close together so that I have 2 weigh-ins in a row where I've had a cheat meal that week. Like, maybe I should just, maybe we should celebrate Valentine's Day early, since I don't care if it's on the actual day or not. Then that way I can kind of have a little bit more breathing room between one cheat meal and the next. So we had kind of talked about it and we decided that that kind of worked out best for both of us. You know, like I said, I personally do not care that much about Valentine's Day. I'm not like a big, oh, you have to buy me flowers and you have to buy me chocolate and you have to do this, da 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 da. I don't really care that much. Like, it's a day like any other day. I like going out to eat with him. I like, you know, having more of like a special like date day with it. But honestly, I don't care if it's actually on Valentine's Day or not. So we decided that this weekend was going to be our Valentine's Day date, just to kind of give me a little bit more breathing room between the cheat meals so that I can kind of, you know, work off one cheat meal before I have the other. So we went to Olive Garden today and I did so well. Like, I am so proud of myself for this, you guys, because Olive Garden is my favorite place to eat. And I don't care if it's not authentic Italian food, and I don't care if people think that it's bad or it's gross or whatever. I personally love Olive Garden, and it stems from being a child, and Olive Garden was kind of a special treat. We really only ever got to eat at Olive Garden when we helped my aunt move when I was a kid, and because she would always move in the cities and stuff, and so we would go eat there. And that was like a special treat. So I just kind of, Olive Garden to me is a special occasion, you know, just one of those places where it brings back memories of being a kid, and it just is something that I really, really enjoy. So I love the breadsticks more than anything in the world. Like, if you know me at all, then you know that I love Olive Garden breadsticks. Like, I could eat like 20 of them. Like, I could eat all the breadsticks. You could like put me back in the kitchen, pull out a big tray of breadsticks, and I would eat them all because they're delicious. And I only had one breadstick this week. It was crazy. Like, I was kind of like looking ahead at their menu and trying to plan a little bit, because I knew like I wanted to be a cheat meal, but I don't want to be like, I'm gonna eat it all, and I'm gonna eat pasta, and I'm gonna eat breadsticks, and I'm gonna eat dessert and eat all this. Like, I was trying to be better, like make a better choice than what I would have done normally at Olive Garden, especially because I haven't really had it since I started profile, because I was really worried that if I went there I would just eat it like crab that's not good for me. So we went and I had the chicken piccata, which is a chicken breast that is kind of layered with a like garlicky, lemony butter sauce that's delicious. And it has like chopped up tomatoes and some other stuff on it, but it's really, really, really good. The side dish to that is actually Parmesan crusted zucchini instead of, I know that they used to have like a rosemary chicken that was very similar, except for it was, you know, obviously like a rosemary butter sauce instead of like a lemony butter sauce. And that came with garlic mashed potatoes. And so that was like more reboot friendly, but not quite. But then I saw that they had, it's called like the lighter fare taste of the Mediterranean. And so we went on the lunch period because A, it's cheaper, and B, it's smaller portion sizes, which fit better in with profile. So I had that, and that was actually only 350 calories. And that's because instead of like mashed potatoes or like a kind of a starchy side, it has a side of zucchini. And it was delicious. Like, I honestly would order that again. And it was nice because we both ordered something that we had never tried before. So I was really proud of myself because I made a better decision than what I normally do. Like, normally when I go to Olive Garden, I get the chicken Alfredo, I eat about 10 breadsticks, I eat the salad that is drenched in salad dressing, and most of the time I don't get a dessert because God knows I never leave enough room for dessert. And this time I had one breadstick, I had the chicken piccata, which was only 350 calories, I had the salad, and I asked for the dressing on the side, and I never even put it on there because I was like, I need to save all my fats for this chicken piccata because I knew it was coming in like a butter sauce. So I honestly went there, was able to enjoy my date, and I don't even know, like, do I count that as a cheat meal? Is that a cheat meal, or is it just a cheat breadstick? Because the only thing that I had there that was not on the profile plan was the breadstick. So I didn't have a cheat meal, I had a cheap breadstick. And it was an amazing breadstick, and I don't regret it at all because I was able to limit myself to just one. And I never thought, like before profile, I never could have limited myself to one breadstick. And I normally get the Alfredo sauce dipping sauce, but I didn't get that because I knew that, you know, that's a lot of extra fat calories right there and I didn't need it. So I was able to make really, really good decisions today, which was really nice on a week that I had plateaued and I was feeling really dejected and really disappointed in my weight loss and kind of frustrated, not kind of, really frustrated that I was still able to make the better decisions and have a delicious meal with my fiance at Olive Garden and not feel guilty about it. Like, I walked away and I was like, I did good. Like, this is good. We had originally talked about having a dessert because we, you know, were on a special date and we knew that they had added a couple of new desserts that Jesse was really, really interested in. And I had decided that I was going to get, they're called like dolcini, I don't know how to pronounce it, but they're like little mini desserts. And one has about, the dark chocolate caramel has about 240 calories and about 14 grams of carbs, which is way better than what their cheesecake has, because their like new Andes mint cheesecake has like 98 grams of carbs in one slice and like 880 calories or something crazy like that. So we decided not to get dessert at the end because we just were super full and there was no way in heck we were gonna fit dessert in as well. But I'm glad that I had a plan in place for if we decided to get dessert. I knew what I was going to get that was going to be not profile friendly, but closer to being profile friendly than what I normally would have gotten, which would have been the slice of that cheesecake. So I'm making way smarter decisions. Profile has taught me how to kind of look at the nutritional value and make choices. Like, you have to make choices. Like, this is a lifestyle change, not a diet. And I hate when people say that because it just sounds so hokey, like, oh, I'm changing my lifestyle. But at the same time, knowing that I can have a meal out and I know how to look at, okay, here's the calories from fat, here's the grams of fat, here's this, here's that. How to weigh what would work the best for me on that given day is probably one of the best skills that I have learned from profile. And knowing how much my, like, my given macros in a day are, I do that all the time. Like, I will look at, I have my Fitness Pal, and I know exactly how many grams of carbs I should have in a day, exactly how many grams of protein, and exactly how many grams of fat I can have in a day. And I make decisions on what type of fat I should have, and if I want cheese, or if I want butter, or if I want, you know, like, the different types of fat and the different types of vegetables based on how, what my macros look like. So if I am, you know, it's coming to be dinner time, or it's after dinner and I'm feeling snacky, I'll look at my macros and say, okay, well, I still have this many carbs to play with, so I can have an extra 2 cups of vegetables, or I can have this. And that's a skill that I can then take after I'm done with profile, or not done with profile, but after I'm in, like, the sustained phase and I've lost the weight, that I now know how to kind of gauge that and how to be honest with myself about what I'm actually eating. Because I've tried dieting in the past, and every time, I've even had my Fitness Pal, and every time I've, like, fudged what I was eating in the day because I've felt, like, ashamed of it, and now I'm not ashamed of it. So I'm really happy that even though this was a really, really frustrating week weight loss wise, that there were still some positives in the week that I can look at and go, you know what, I didn't lose any weight this week, but I'm more confident in my ability to go out to restaurants and make better choices, and I am way more confident when I move into the adapt phases and into sustain that I will be able to kind of balance that a lot better than what I, you know, originally I was a little bit nervous that, like, when I finally go to adapt, am I going to go crazy and not be able to stay on plan? But today kind of showed me that I think I'll be able to stay on plan even when they start adding back in a lot more starches and a lot more carbs. So yay for that! The other positive thing that happened this week is I had 2 people at work come up and comment on my weight loss, which also felt really good on a plateau week because, you know, even if it is not, you know, even if I haven't lost weight this week, I still had good things. Good things happened. I'm still really happy that I joined profile. I'm still really happy with my weight loss so far. And next week might be better. Who knows? I might be coming to you next week and say, oh, I lost 2 pounds, or, you know, maybe hopefully even 0.5 pound. Like, anything would be better than what I did this week. But again, good things still happened. I'm still going to be positive, and I'm still going to look forward, and I still really, really think that I can make that 3rd goal. I know I can. I'm gonna get there. If you guys like this video, please hit that like button. Also subscribe so you can follow me along on Operation Lose the Baby Hippo and see if I lose any more weight next week. I will see you then. I almost forgot. If you guys have any suggestions for how to break a plateau, just in case next week I don't lose anything and I'm really frustrated, then please let me know in the comments down below. I've already reached out to the profile member group Facebook page and gotten some great feedback there, but for any of you that maybe aren't on profile, anything that you do that kind of helps you break that, like, weight loss stall, let me know, because I could, you know, really use the help, because I really don't want to stall again next week. I really want to lose something. All right, I will see you guys next week.